We did not see Eid Mubarak, may Allah accept from you the Siyam of the year. Just a small a reminder before we talk about in Eid about the Rahim, next and kin and the relatives and the importance to keep in touch with them. Last Friday we talked about the importance of the parents, obedience of the parents. Today we talk about the brothers and sisters. And this is also important, inshallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَهُوَ الَّذِي خَلَقَ مِنَ الْمَاءِ بَشَرًا فَجَعَلَهُ نَسَبًا وَسِهْرًا. He created from the water a human being, and he make it as a more a form of human being that has brothers, and that has the sons, brothers, kids, the son of the brother. So, my dear brothers, the brotherhood in Islam is very important. And there is different kind of brotherhood. Allah mentions in the Quran. Brothers for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that people who meet for each other for the sake of Allah. Maybe he's from China and you are made to be from Colombia or Alaska. You meet for Allah and you start love that person for Allah because he's obedient. He is devoted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you tell him, I love you for the sake of Allah. So you have no country, no flag, no language, nothing that gather you except the a'mal that you see this man doing, and you love him. And this is one of the highest brotherhood in the deen. Why? Because it stays forever. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say in the Quran, إِخْوَانًا عَلَى سُرُرٍ مُتَقَابِلِينَ. The brotherhood for Allah, they will meet in the Jannah. And in the Day of Judgment, the people in hell, they will say, فَمَا لَنَا مِنْ شَافِعِينَ وَلَا صَدِيقٍ حَمِينَ. Scholar they say in Tafsir, the brothers for Allah, they intercede. If one of them has made some shortcomings, and Allah did not, for example, put him in pending situation, they intercede, so Allah forgive him. So there is the brothers for Allah. There is the brothers of shaitan. Allah says in the Quran, إِنَّ الْمُبَذِّرِينَ كَانُوا إِخْوَانَ الشَّيَاطِينَ. So when the person do so many bad, he become the brother of shaitan. There is brothers of hypocrites. Hypocrites, they have their brothers. Because the birds, they fall on their kind. And this is why we have to work hard on our heart, because if a people love backbiting, they don't like some people to be their friend if they don't backbite. They say, I don't get along with him. He's not in my mood. He has to sit with the people who love this kind of sin so he can enjoy it. So if he talk to someone all the time when he backbites, he says, tell him stop, don't talk about this. He says he is not my good friend. Also, the hypocrites, they have their brothers. Allah says in the Quran, أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى الَّذِينَ نَافَقُوا يَقُولُونَ لِإِخْوَانِهِمْ. They say to their brothers. It means hypocrites, similar. And there's the brothers, many brothers, which is topic today, brothers from the same father and mother. Now, the brother from the same father and mother, mighty brothers, is one of the most biggest concern of the father or mother when they die. After Iman, the father and mother, they want to die on Iman, but what the concern that they have is how their kids will stay together after their death. How the construction that they made for 30, 40, 50 years will not be demolished by the shaitan or by the wife's brother or wife's sister or whatever, husband's sister or whatever. So this construction is the main concern of the parents. And that's why it has been reported in the book of Ruh. There is a book Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyya wrote, it's called The Soul. In this book, it has been reported that when the people die in the barzakh, if they are in Jannah, not people of hell, they will not have this permission. But if they are in Jannah, the angel, when they come to them, they ask them in the sky, because the soul of the Muslim who die on Iman, they are in Illiyin. كَلَّا إِنَّ كِتَابَ الْأَبْرَارِ لَفِي عليين. So when they meet the angel, they ask them about their kids. So if they say that their kids, they are divided, they fight for the money, and they scatter, and they hate each other, they cry, and they say, Allah, yani unite between them. So you have to have conviction. I'm talking about anyone whose parents passed away. They enter, and they, if they go in Jannah, they have this concern. How you can keep in touch with your brothers and sisters. You cannot cut this link, because you don't hurt yourself or hurt your brothers only. You are hurting the parents that died and they received this bad news about you. And this is one of the worst sin. Because ulama, they said, what is the major sin in the Quran? The major sin in the Quran is any sin that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised. Anger, ghadab, or hell, or curse. In the Qati'at al-Rahim, there is a curse. فَهَلْ عَسَيْتُمْ إِن تَوَلَّيْتُمْ أَن تُفْسِدُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَتُقَطِّعُوا أَرْحَامَكُمْ أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ لَعَنَهُمُ اللَّهِ فَأَصَمَّهُمْ وَأَعْمَى أَبْصَارَهُمْ. So the main concern of the parent with the die, how the brothers and sisters, they stay together. And that's why one of the pious men, when he was in the deathbed, the story everybody know, and actually the story you learn it when you were a kid. But it's good. The purpose is not how simple is the story, but to take a lesson. This father, when he was in the deathbed, he has the pieces of wood according to the number of kids he has surrounding him in the deathbed. So he asked everyone to break it, separate. So everyone can break it easily. Then he bring the same number of woods, which is the number of his kids, and he tied it on a rope, and he asked everyone to break it. Nobody can, it's too hard. So he says, this piece of wood is you. If you stay together, you love each other, protect each other, help each other, you will be strong. You will be united, no one can divide you. But if you scatter and everybody look for his own interest, you will be like this piece of wood, which will be easily broken by the shaitan and by your nafs and desire. So the unity of the brothers and sisters is extremely important. Allah gave us many examples in the Quran, and we are going to mention some. Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam, as you know, Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, when he talked to Allah in the mountains of Tur, he asked Allah an extra question, because Allah wants to send him to Fir'aun. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can transfer the message, even though Musa has difficulty of speaking. Musa used to have يَتَلَعْثَمْ فِي الْكَلَامِ. He used to have difficulty of speaking. But Allah's order come to Musa only. Musa, what he says? He says, وَاجْعَلْ لِي وَزِيرًا مِنْ أَهْلِي هَارُونَ أَخِي أُشْدُدْ بِهِ أَزْرِي وَأَشْرِكُهُ فِي أَمْرِي كَيْ نُسَبِّحَكَ كَثِيرًا وَنَذْكُرَكَ كَثِيرًا. Musa asked a demand from Allah. He said, oh Allah, make for me a minister that will help me to convey your message to Fir'aun, Harun, my brother. Allah told him, قَدْ أُوتِيتَ سُؤْلَكَ يَا مُوسَى. I grant your dua. And Allah make Harun a prophet. Abdullah ibn Saud, he says, أَمَنُّ النَّاسِ, the most, the people who give the biggest favor over their brother in the history of humankind is Musa. Because favor here is not he make him rich, or he make him finish education. He, because of his dua, Allah select Harun to be Nabi, a prophet. And in the Mi'raj, Rasulullah said, I saw Harun on the fifth sky. And ulama, they said here, the skies is the maqam of the prophets. So Harun was right below Musa, and Musa was right below Ibrahim. Other, they said, is the maqam of the sacrifice. Harun sacrificed a lot, because Isa is way better than Harun, no doubt, because he's from Ulu Azm, and he was on the second sky. Anyway, so Musa, he did favor to his brother. And Harun, when Musa went to the Tur, and he came back and he find Banu Israel worshipping the idol, He got extremely angry at his brother and he started pulling him from the bier. The bier has been mentioned in the Quran. That's why, brother, we have to know that the bier is not only sunnah of Rasulullah. The bier is the sunnah of the prophets. Because Allah mentioned the Quran. Allah loved the answer of Harun. Because Musa, last word he said to Harun, خلفني في أهلي. You become my Khalifa now when I go to meet Allah. But when Musa come, he find Banu Israel worshipping the cow from the gold. So he threw the stones that has the graved the words of Allah, the Torah, and he grabbed the hair of his brother. His brother, what he says, I was afraid that you will say you divide, you split Banu Israel into group with you and group with Samiri. And he did not wait my decision. This answer was so powerful that Allah make it in the Quran. What does it mean? It means the unity is extremely important when there is a minor issue. Now this issue is shirk, but why he keep them united on the shirk? Because he know when Musa will come and he will announce, all of them they will shift to the truth, to follow Musa. But if he split them together, there will be fight and war and they will kill each other. So he keep them together in the battle till Musa will come and then they will shift to the Haqq. So when Bani Israel keep giving hard time to Musa, at the last stage, Musa did not forget his brother. Look, subhanallah. He says, Rabbi اغفر لي ولي أخي. Oh Allah, forgive me and my brother. وَأَدْخِلْنَا فِي رَحْمَتِكَ and put us inside your rahmah. Before that, the sister of Musa, when the mother threw him in the well, and the small box of where the baby Musa was going towards the palace of Fir'aun, and ulama scholar, they said, the box was going against the speed. The speed was going the opposite side of the palace of Fir'aun, because Fir'aun's palace was such that the river was flowing, going down and going this. So the box was going against the speed. The Qudra of Allah and the Mashi'a of Allah. To teach us that Allah's will over the will of any creation. وَمَا تَشَاءُنَا إِلَّا أَنْ يَشَاءَ اللَّهُ رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ. So the mother of Musa said to his sister, قُصِّيه. قُصِّيه means follow him in a way that they will not remark that you are following that baby. So she followed till he came to the palace. So when they have the issue of who will breastfeed him, she came. And then she said, and she was extremely smart. She said, هَلْ أَدُلُّكُمْ عَلَىٰ أَهْلِ بَيْتٍ يَكْفُلُونَهُ وَهُمْ لَهُ نَاصِحُونَ. Can I show you? Because that time, the ladies that were there, none of them accept Musa, accept to take her milk. So she said, she take that occasion and say, can I show you family that will be very good to this baby and they will be kind to him. So the Fir'aun was smart also. He says, how do you know that these people that have this house that you want to show it to us, they will be kind to this baby? They have doubt on her. He says, maybe this is his sister. But right away she was so smart, she said, no, because you are the king. And they want to take some of your blessing. Then they come down and they give it to her. So who take this risk? A sister that take a risk to be dead for her own brother. Allah give us this example, brother, so we can stop and see how is our relationship with our brothers and sisters now. How our relationship with them. How we are kind to them. How we take care of them. How we call to follow up on them. This is something extremely important. Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam, when he saw the dream, in short, and the father, he did not tell the dream to his brothers. The brothers, they don't know about the dream. But they just see that the father, Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam, he starts giving more care to Yusuf. So they feel jealous. Such jealousy, may Allah save us, that they decide to kill him. اقتلوا يوسف او القوه في غيابة الجب. So anyway, they decide to throw him in the well, in the darkness of the well. Now these brothers,
they get rid of their own young brother. And after many years, Yusuf suffered. He suffered the slavery. He has been sold in the market of slaves. He suffered the fitna of the woman in the palace of Zulikha. He suffered the jail for many years. Not 1 or 2 months, many years. And then he suffered separation from his father till he became blind. How many hardship? Now, I'm talking to anyone who doesn't talk to his brother. Can your brother do to you what Yusuf did to the brothers, Yusuf did to his, their brothers? But Yusuf, alayhi salatu wasalam, his brothers, in the position of power, he's the minister, the treasurer of Egypt. He can just say, put them in the jail, hang them on the open land. He can just decide. But at that position, when they come to him and they said, forgive us, he says, لا تتريب عليكم. Never mind. Not only that, scholar, they said, he attributed the sin to the shaitan. من بعد أن نزغ الشيطان بيني وبين إخوتي. Shaitan came between me and my own brothers. He didn't even attribute the mistake to them. And this is called ta'wil al-akhta. Ta'wil al-akhta, it means to find excuses no matter what. Rasulullah gave a beautiful example. He says, if your brother has 99 faults and one good thing, look to that good thing. Don't look to the 99. How about if this is your brother that comes from the same womb? Your blood that circulates on your nerve, it circulates in his nerve. You are same blood. How come you cut off your leg for a few dollars? Or for just small mistake that he did? Who does not make a mistake among us? We are making mistakes. We are committing sin day and night. You are not an angel. And Rasulullah said to the man, if you want that Allah forgive you, learn, because this is called education. You have to learn. This is not something that comes right away. You have to learn how to forgive. So the people who do not forgive, they are far from Allah and His Rasul. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, من شر الناس قال من لا يقبل عذرا ولا يغفر زلتان. The worst person is the man who does not forgive a mistake, nor he pardon a sin. الحجاز بن يوسف الثقفي, when he take hold of a family of Kharijiya, Khawarij that time, they were, anyway, this is not time to talk about it. He hold her husband, her brother, and her son. He says, take one, I'm going to kill two. So he hold three, her husband, her son, her brother. He says, select one out of these three because two will be dead. What she said, look, subhanAllah, the knowledge of this woman. She said, Az-zawju mawjud, husband is available. If my husband go today, I found another husband. Wal ibnu mawlud, and the son can be born. I can get another son. Wal akhu mafqud, and the brother can never be replaced. Al-Hajjaj say, أطلقوهم كلهم لفقهها. Release them all because of her deep understanding. The brothers from your mother and father can never come again. And I'm very shocked, my dear brothers. I'm very shocked. I hear some talks and some people who talk to me and some news. People don't talk to their own brothers and sisters for years. Which heart we are holding, brother? Wallah al-Azim, we have to cry. Which kind of heart we have? More hard than the stone. And sometimes a husband listens to the wife more than he listens to his own brothers and sisters. This is called blind love. I'm not here talking about all. There is all the time good husband, good wives. But I'm saying that the wife should understand that the father and mother and brother and sister are a red tag. You cannot touch. Rasulullah su'il, من أبر الناس؟ من أبر؟ قال الله رسولاً بر أباك وأمك ثم أخاك وأختك ثم الأقرب فالأقرب. Be kind to your mother and father, then to your brother and sister, then to the closest to them. So you have to be nice to your wife, but you cannot let your wife interfere in your matter with your brothers and sisters. except if he is unjust.
She has to talk for her right, because everybody has to fulfill the rights. He cannot deprive the right of his wife, so he can fulfill the right of his brother. Because between brackets, some brothers abuse, some sister abuse, and some people, they don't know how to be fair. Rasulullah, when he received Shayma bint al-Harith, the daughter of Halim al-Sa'diyah, and she has been catched by the Sabi, by the Sahaba, they did not know that this is the Rasulullah's sister from the breastfeeding. So she said to them, "Ana ukhtu sahibukum." I am the sister of Rasulullah. So they did not believe her. When they brought her to Rasulullah, Rasulullah didn't know her. Then she mentioned a sign that Rasulullah has. Some scholars, they said the stitches on his chest. So Rasulullah removed his kameez, his jupa, he spread it on the earth, and he hugged her and said, "My sister." Then he gave her the choice. He says to her, "Do you want to stay with me, Mu'azzazat al-Mukarrama? You want to stay here with me? I will take care of you. You don't need anything. Or you want to go back to your tribe?" She said, "No, Prophet of Allah, take me back to my tribe." And she accepted Islam. Rasulullah gave her three slave servants, and one servant girl, and too many camels and sheep. And ulama, they said, in the Khilafah of Abu Bakr Siddiq, Banu Sa'd, the tribe Banu Sa'd, they were in the border to become atheists, to deny Islam. And Shayma stand up, and she talk with so much concern, and she bring back her tribe to Islam. Allahu Akbar. So how Rasulullah gave us example about the brotherhood, how they should be. So scholars, they said, what is the reason why we have this scattered? Number one is the money. And what is this money? Is sand, dust. That's why, because of the lack of iman, people get the money to build big houses, big cars, and they go to visit their poor brothers, and they start show off. "I have this, I have this." This is ignorance. You show off for what? From the fadl of Allah that Allah asked you. And he mentioned on you in the Quran, وَفِي أَمْوَالِهِمْ حَقٌ مَعْلُومٌ لِلسَّائِلِ وَالْمَحْرُومِ. How about if this bright man is your own brothers and sisters? So my dear brothers, scholars, they said, number one is the money. Number two, listening to the wife for issues that is personal. And that's why, at least to be fair, listen from your wife till she finish, and listen from the other side, so you can have a fair judgment. You cannot listen from one wife, from one side, or else you become like a blind from one eye. He cannot give clear view. That's why scholars, they said, there was one story. A man, he died and he left a land. So two brothers, they shared this land. So they said, in spite of cutting this land and selling it and everyone take half, let's work on this land and share the crop. After a while, the woman and the fair, they start fight, and they said, "You know what, let's split it then now." So they split it. And he built his house, front of the house of his brother. And they work each one on the land. Then the problem pick up worse. They hate each other. So one day, one of the brothers decide to go for 1 week travel. So he called a construction man. He says, "I want to give you a task. The house front of me is my brother's house. I don't want to look to his face. I don't want to see nobody come from this face, from this house. So please build for me a wall that separates this house from my view. I don't want to see anything about them. They are only troublemaker." So the construction man, he tell him, "It's okay, come after 1 week, it will be done." When he was coming after 1 week and he looked to his house, you know what he find? He find the construction man build a bridge between his house and the house of his own brother. Then his brother doesn't know about it. He doesn't know that his brother hired the construction to make wall. He thought that he hired him to build the bridge. So he come in the reception of his brother, he hug him and cry and says, "Forgive me, brother." And the other brother cry and they become reconciled. So it's just one word, one humbleness,
one press against the nafs, and that's all, everything will be reconciled. Why? Because this is your own brother. This is your own sister. They love you no matter what. And nobody will be care about you more than your brother and sister. Luqman, when he come after many years, and he asked his neighbor, what happened to my father? He says, he died. He says, I become independent, responsible. When he tell him, your mother died, he says, my concern is gone. When he tell him, your sister died, he says, my awra, my private has been covered. And when he told him, your brother died, he says, my back has been broken. Allah say in the Quran, سَنَشُدُّ عَدُدَكَ بِأَخِيكَ. Think deep about this word. سَنَشُدُّ عَدُدَكَ بِأَخِيكَ. We will give you strength by the help of your brother. So that's why we should be humble. Don't think that your money or any position, it's the one that make you privileged. What make you privileged is your qualities. Be humble. Talk to your brother and say, be humble and say, I am sorry. Even if the other person is tired, tell him, I am sorry, brother. I will never lose my blood. I will never cut the link of my blood. And you'll see how Allah will shower his rahmah on you. Allah united us. Assalamu alaikum.